So over the coming weeks I'm going to be talking about a lot of the new features in macOS Mojave. So let's take an overview right now and look at some of the best new features. So here's one. Inside of System Preferences in general you can now switch to Dark Mode. And Dark Mode gives you dark backgrounds with light text. Works throughout the system and in a lot of apps as well. You also have Accent Color at the bottom here just underneath. You've got the ability to change the accent color from the default there. You also have something called Dynamic Desktop. So under Desktop Screensaver you can go in and you can choose the default Mojave Dynamic Desktop which will change over the course of the day. There's also another one that's just basically a solid gradient. And you can also choose the standard desktop backgrounds as well. Now looking in the Finder we've got a new view called Gallery View. And this is the fourth view after Icons, List, Column, and now it's Gallery View instead of Cover Flow. And Gallery View gives you the files at the bottom and you can see a nice preview of it here. Also the preview pane on the right has the ability to show lots of information. So you can hit the Show More button here and you could see you could get lots of information depending upon what you've got in the left side here, whether it's an image or whatever. You also have actions called quick actions underneath. So for images, for instance, I could rotate left. For video, I could trim. And there's always a markup tool for things like PDF and image files as well. And you can add more like create PDF or third-party apps can add more of these quick actions as well. On the left side, you've got some changes to the sidebar. Now it's favorites, iCloud, and locations. So that's the main categories you've got there. Now, on the desktop, you've got something called stacks. So if I were to put a bunch of images, say, on the desktop here, and then I wanted to kind of clean my desktop up a little bit, I could turn on stacks and it will group things like images all together in one stack and I could expand them and bring them back like that. You also have the ability to see the recent apps you're using here on the right side of the dock. So the dock now has three sections. The left side which is applications like before. The right side which is documents, folders, and the trash. And you have this middle section here which shows you currently running apps that aren't on the left side of the dock and apps you've recently run so you can easily get back to them. This is similar to iOS. System updates are now under System Preferences. So when you go into System Preferences there's software update there for the system. You still update apps in the App Store app. So one of my favorite new features is something called Continuity Camera and that is the ability in an app like Preview or in anything that you're you can bring an image in, you can bring an image in from your iPhone or iPad. And here I don't have an iPhone or iPad using this Apple ID, but I'll show you in a future tutorial how you can actually bring one in using your iPhone as a camera and it just instantly brings it in. In addition to that, you've also got a new way to capture the screen. The old keyboard shortcuts still work, but you can do Shift-Command-5 and you can now bring up this little control strip here where you can capture the entire screen, a window, a portion of it. You can do a screen recording to video. You can choose options like where to save and whether there's a delay in the capture and that kind of thing. So you have much expanded keyboard shortcut for screen capture that just, you know, you just got to remember one thing, Shift-Command-5, and that's how you bring that about. You've also got a lot of new apps. For instance, here's the News app, which is from iOS and now it works on Mac as well. In addition to News, you've got a Stocks app, you've got Voice Memos as well, and even a Home app so you can actually control lights and power and stuff in your home from your Mac as well as from iOS devices. There's also a rewritten DVD player app. If you still have an optical drive, it's now 64-bit compatible, so that app will live on at least for a few more years. And the Books app is new. It's basically a redesigned iBooks app with a new store in it. But other than that, it's just really kind of a minor update. One last thing I want to show you is in Safari now, you can bring up tabs as before. So I can do multiple tabs and you can turn on the icons for that. So I can go into Preferences and I can under the tabs, you see it says Show Website Icons and Tabs. If you turn that on then you'll see the tabs and you can see the Apple logo next to Apple. You can see the Mac Most logo next to Mac Most.
Thank you.